Mr. Prime Minister, as a non-aligned, as a member of the non-aligned group of nations, do you feel that Dr. Castro's speech at the UN accurately represented your views?
I think it faithfully reflected the decisions that were taken at the non-aligned conference. The only addition, I would say, would have related to the specific figure for how much assistance.
The financial aid,
yes,
you're talking about.
The developed world, and as you put it, the developing world, should contribute over the next 10 years.
Would you specifically have demanded more funds?
No, I don't think so. I think that is a realistic figure, but I think it's also pretty much a minimum figure.
Do you feel that Castro professes to speak on behalf of the non-aligned nations? Mm-hmm. Do you see him as a messiah of sorts, a champion to represent the views of those nations?
I think he was duly agreed upon by certainly a vast majority of countries attending a non-aligned conference in Havana. And I believe that most of those countries would certainly share the views of Grenada, that his choice at this point was a good one.
What about in the future?
Every 3 years there are new choices made, and I think we should wait to see what happens then. I couldn't really speak to 3 years from now.
Other than the specific amount of aid which you mentioned, mm-hmm. is there anything else that he spoke of that you disagreed with?
I didn't disagree with the amount of aid. And so far, specific points made by President Castro, there's nothing in the speech that I can concretely and specifically pull out as an area of disagreement so far as our own foreign policy is concerned. As you realize, he more or less stayed away from foreign policy issues that were not mentioned or agreed upon at the non-aligned conference. And therefore, there were very few views that were specifically the views of Cuba. There's really nothing I can think of at this point that, you know, we would disagree with.
Let's talk about your position within the group of non-aligned mm-hmm. nations. My understanding was that at the Havana conference, Dr. Castro wanted to move the nations towards a Soviet bloc mm-hmm. interest, yet President mm-hmm. Tito of Yugoslavia mm-hmm. wanted to move everyone to a middle-of-the-road course. That's what was decided. Mm-hmm. Where's your position? Where does your country stand?
I don't really accept your premise to begin with. I don't think that's a fair assessment of either position. My own feeling is that there was really a big blow-up, mainly by some elements in the press, on this question. I think it turned out to be a non-issue at the conference, basically. I think that, you know, a substantial number of countries in the non-aligned world do have their own strong views on the question of which of the two worlds, socialist or capitalist, tend to back them on particular causes. You look at Angola, Mozambique, you look at Vietnam, Cambodia, or you look at the Palestinian struggle today, and I think it is fair to say that very often there is a convergence of views, you know, between one world and the non-aligned bloc. I do not see this as a conspiracy. I see this as being an affinity that is based on analysis that is made by different countries.
Let me interrupt and ask you this. Dr. Castro has accused the West of exploiting the poor. He is against mm-hmm. capitalism. Do you mm-hmm. share that view?
Against capitalism would not be our position. We are certainly against imperialism. Oh yes, we are against that, certainly.
But
we define imperialism in a very specific way.
And that is?
Well, that is to say the countries, the governments that back their multinational, transnational corporations with the use or the threat of force. That would be our major concern. It's not so much, in other words, a question of whether or not a particular country has multinational corporations that are investing in particular areas. It is a question of to what extent are they willing to go to back the interests of those corporations.
So you obviously can rationalize that despite the fact you are anti-imperialist, mm-hmm. you are encouraging foreign aid mm-hmm. from the capitalist countries and
sure.
financiers that
sure.
you oppose.
Sure.
You want that aid.
Sure.
And you can rationalize that?
Oh, it's easy to rationalize because...
How so?
Well, like I said, it's a question of whether or not the particular governments in which the corporations are based are willing to use force or to threaten force to back the policies of their corporations. That is the essential dividing line for us. Because after all, there are countries all around the world, in Europe, in North America, and elsewhere, that do have big companies investing. Not all of them react in the same way.
What do you mean by force? Do you mean a military presence?
A military presence would be included if that military presence is meant to intimidate the people of a particular region.
Are you therefore against President Carter's mm-hmm. additional employment of military presence in that area?
Jamaica, Guyana, St. Lucia, Grenada have already come out with a very strong joint statement condemning this new idea. We are against it, yes.
Do you welcome the idea of Soviet troops in the area?
No, we don't welcome any troops in the area. Our position is that the Caribbean should be a zone of peace.
So what do you think the solution is?
I think the solution is for the troops to be removed. All the troops.
How so? What do you think would convince Dr. Castro to do that?
I don't think the immediate issue, quite frankly, is one of Dr. Castro. I think the most immediate issue here is the latest maneuvers by the Americans. And the reason I say this is that President Carter himself, in his speech, has pretty much made it clear that the troops have been there for quite a long time. He says mid-70s, probably earlier. The Cubans, as I understand, say since 62. He also says they pose no direct threat to the U.S. or anybody else in the region. Therefore, one has to ask, why then the build-up at this point?
Okay, just briefly, one more mm-hmm. question. Your country has just gone through a revolution. Mm-hmm. You're moving it along towards socialist lines. Mm-hmm. You do want foreign aid in order mm-hmm. to get your country back mm-hmm. on its feet again. Mm-hmm. Why are you here in Canada now?
I'm here mainly to speak with your Prime Minister Clark, tomorrow.
And to ask him what?
Well, to discuss possibilities of technical and economic cooperation, assistance, and aid.
Have you had any indication from our government how forthcoming they would be in that area?
I would not want to make any statement on that until after tomorrow. I think we should wait to see what happens tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister.
Thank you.